Hello, this is Thomas from Hotkey404, and in this video I'll show you how to create self-signed certificate in Asterisk and switch from UDP to TLS registrations. If you're here, probably you know why to use TLS while securing your Asterisk. It provides this extra layer of security. In case you don't know, let's give an example. Let's say someone connected to your network and captured all the traffic. In this example, using Wireshark, you can see that you can see a lot of information regarding SIP communication. But if you switch to TLS, most of that just disappears. However, there are plenty of scenarios where you might want to use TLS in your case. In most cases, you will just create self-signed certificate and connect your phones, your soft phones, to your Asterisk via TLS instead of regular UDP. You might want to also convince your phones that this self-signed certificate authority is actually trusted. Or maybe, for some reason, although it is not recommended, your Asterisk is on public IP address, open to the world, then definitely you might want to consider using TLS in your case, using some bots, SSL certificate, or even completely free Let's Encrypt. Or there's a different scenario where your Asterisk is not a server, but actually a client, and you want to connect your Asterisk to some remote Asterisk using TLS. So today we'll handle the first scenario, and we will create self-signed certificate. And in case you want to follow along all those commands, I encourage you to visit our website, hotkey404.com. In blog section, you will find this article and you can just copy paste some of those commands. So let's get started. Let's start with generating a certificate. The easiest way to do this is with a ready-made script that comes with our software. If you don't have the source files, you can download any version of the software from Asterisk servers. We will download Asterisk 16, and for some order and maybe convenience, we can go to USR SRC directory, and here we will do wget and the link to our software. For simplicity, of course, all of these commands can be found on our website. Now let's unpack the file with tar and then -zxvf and our file. Now cd into the Asterisk contrib scripts directory and let's use ls. As you can see, we have some pre-made scripts inside and we will use the one called AstTLSCert. But before we do this, it is worth checking one more thing. Let's enter Asterisk console with *-r. If at the start you see information about the user and the group, in our case it's Asterisk, it is worth executing all of the commands as the mentioned user. So to switch, let's execute su Asterisk. And with whoami you can verify if that worked. As a new user, let's create a directory to store our keys. It can be virtually anywhere on a server. We will do mkdir etc asterisk keys. Why that? Because why not? However, if for some reason you forgot to change the user, you can make up for it as root at any given time with the command chown -r asterisk and then etc asterisk keys. Otherwise, if we set up certificate as wrong user, log into the console and do, for example, SIP reload, we will see a lot of errors. But after executing the mentioned chown -r asterisk and etc asterisk keys, SIP reload will not throw any more errors.
Returning to our asterisk, we can now generate the certificate authority and the certificate key. To do this, assuming that we are in a directory with the source files, in our case, USR, SRC, asterisk with our version, contrib scripts, we will run the command ast_tls-cert and then -c and let's say pbx1.mycompany.local, and we say local because we use local IP, not a public one, hence this self-signed certificate. Then O option and the name of our company, and D for destination, etc asterisk keys. Now we will be asked to set a password for the main CA key and then repeat it. This will create a local certificate authority. Then we will use the same password to create the asterisk.key and the file asterisk.pm, which is the combination of the key and the certificate. The good news is that the keys were automatically added with read-only permissions. We can check it with the command ls-l etc asterisk keys. If for some reason you have different permissions, you can change them with the command chmode 600 etc asterisk keys asterisk dot asterisk. So at this point, we have our keys and files ready. First, let's see how to add TLS support in SIP channels. We will do this by editing our file, which in most cases can be found in /etc/sip.conf. We will add everything in the general section. If there is a variable defining the default transport, UDP in our case, let's add TLS to it. And it is worth mentioning that the order in which we entered the protocols is important. If you start with TLS, it will try to connect with TLS first. Next, let's add the variables TLS enable and it equals yes, TLS certificate and our path, etc asterisk keys and asterisk.pm. Then we can reload the settings with SIP reload from our console. So let's do that. So *-r and SIP reload. Already at this point, we can see the correct loading of the certificates. SIP show settings will also confirm it. Of course, there are more options to configure the connection. For example, we can add variables like TLS cipher or TLS client method to specify encryption methods, or for example, TLS bind address to define the IP and listening port. Also, we've used a general section, but instead of that, you can define TLS for each individual device. Now, let's check out our configuration. And to do this, let's register one SIP account. After entering data such as username and password, let's use TLS instead of UDP and change port from 5060 to 5061. The phone will register and this registration information will appear in the asterisk console. As you can see, the phone has registered successfully with TLS. So that's it. For PJSIP, the situation is very similar, but before we go into the configuration, let's go back for a moment to our /etc/sip.conf file. If we want to use SIP and PJSIP simultaneously, let's change the port's bind address to 000 and port 5070 and TLS bind address, let's specify after zeros port 5071. Then in the console, let's reload the settings with SIP reload. Now we are listening on other ports, so we can go back to pjsip.conf. So let's edit it with our favorite nano editor. So nano ecc asterisk pjsip.conf. Contrary to sip.conf, here we add a separate context with a transport. Let's call it inside the bracket transport-tls. And inside, let's add the following minimal variables. Type, transport, protocol, TLS, bind. Let's set a default 000 with port 5061. And instead of having just one file, like with SIP, here we have to define two. Cert file, which will be etc asterisk keys asterisk .crt, our certificate. And in the same way, private key file, which is prif key file etc asterisk keys asterisk .key. After saving the file, let's go to our Asterisk console, and I don't know who came up with it, but there is no PJSIP reload. So let's reload the entire module using module reload res underscore pjsip.so. Then if we type pjsip show transports, it will display that we are listening for TLS registrations on port 5061. And according to the documentation, there is no need to define transport for each individual end device. The system will select it automatically. And once again, after registering our phone, the system will display this new PJSIP contact registered on TLS.
So as you can see, creating and using TLS is not so difficult. So we have handled the first of many scenarios, more in the series in upcoming weeks. So I hope you enjoyed it and see you in the next one.